We've talked a lot about American television evangelists on this show, and we've talked a lot about transsexuals. But so far, American television evangelist transsexuals have been a neglected field. In their country of origin, they are a vocal minority, and no one is more vocal than Larry Nielsen, otherwise known as Sister Paula. Sister Paula has her own little show on cable, on which she proves she is no shrinking violet, although she might conceivably be a shrinking Victor.
Stop! Whatever it is you're doing right now, for you are about to witness scenes of the most unique, creative, and controversial form of televangelism in the United States today. This is Paula Nielsen. I'm happy to say that I am a Christian transsexual. I know the Lord as my Savior. I know that I have been cleansed and forgiven of my sins and born again by the Spirit of God. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Has the God of supernatural power and demonstrations departed? Has that God died? No, he is just as alive and well today as he ever was. I always love opening with that wonderful scripture. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. And if you're a child of God, if you have that one-on-one relationship with God, you have every reason in the world to rejoice because you are rich. You're a child of the King, the one who owns the cattle on a thousand hills. Time and time again, God keeps trying to say to the church world, and they can't seem to grasp it. Preachers are just as human as anyone else.
Sister Paula and God understand each other, which just leaves us. We are sometimes slow to accept that judgment, like vengeance, belongs to the Lord. But why don't we seek guidance from Sister Paula herself, currently ready to join us by satellite from her earthly base in Portland, Oregon. Can you hear me, Sister Paula?
Yes, I can.
Paula, you're looking absolutely sensational. Where do you get those clothes?
Well, you don't get them off of the rack at Sears and Roebuck or Motor Day or in a retail store, that's for sure. This is a show business outfit that I wear as a cabaret entertainer in a nightclub here in Portland, although I've also preached the gospel on television in this very outfit that you're looking at right now. But we get the fabric from various theatrical fabric companies in New York, and then I have colleagues in show business here that make the wardrobe for me. I myself don't sew, but I know several dresses here in Portland that make the dresses for me, and a very dear friend of mine made this outfit for me.
I presume that magnificent head of hair isn't entirely yours.
No, it's not, although sometimes on my cable television show I do use my own hair, but this here is a wig, and it's got a heart on, as you can see. And in any form of entertainment, whether I'm preaching or entertaining in the cabaret, I use all of this in my routines.
You've been doing the Sister Paula show now for nearly 3 years. Who actually watches it?
That's the thing that is sensational about it that just blows me away. When I first started the Sister Paula ministry, the first time an open transsexual or a drag queen preaching the gospel, I had no idea how the public was going to react to it. But I've been on the air now for almost 3 years, and I have people of all walks of life that watch my ministry regularly. I have church people, evangelicals, Pentecostals who watch me, the charismatic folk, and also the non-church world is watching. I have gay people and straight people, people of all walks of life, that they come across me, you know, and they're flicking through the various cable channels, and at first, of course, what they look at stops them, but then they stop and they listen to what I have to say. And a good percentage of these people that I pick up, the channel clickers, you know, I pick them up as regular fans.
Sister Paula, don't some people think your show's a spoof?
Yes, they do at first until they watch it. You know, just recently I had Fred Willard, who is a national television host here in America, who is making appearances on various cable access shows all across the country, and in the Northwest, out of several shows, he picked mine to appear on. And when he was interviewed by the press hereafter, he and I taped the show together. He said that when he heard about me and about the, quote, drag evangelist and all that, he thought it was just a put on. But once he worked on the show with me, he realized that I was dead serious about my religious commitment and my spiritual experience. And he even said that I reminded him of his aunt.
Just to clear up any confusion, you label yourself as a gay transsexual, but you're still a male biologically, is that right?
That is correct. I don't really consider myself to be, quote, gay, unquote. Well, yes and no, but that's neither here nor there. But yes, I feel that the term transsexual comes closest to describing where I'm coming from. Dr. Harry Benjamin, who coined the word transsexual initially, meant the term to mean those people who feel that their psychological sex is the opposite of their biological sex. And somebody can be a transsexual with that definition, whether they've had sex change surgery or not.
Paula, you've been an entertainer since you were a small boy called Larry. What do you remember about those days?
Well, I remember when I was 9 years old, I lived on my grandmother's farm in a small town here in Oregon called Sherwood. And we had 9 or 10 cows, and I was a movie buff. And I, even back then, I loved to get up, you know, in school functions and entertain and perform. And I used to get out in the cow pasture in the middle of the afternoon. This was when I was only 9 years old, and get up on the stumps, the tree stumps, and the cows would be sitting out in the field chewing their cud. And I would get up on the stump with a coffee can as a microphone and entertain the cows.
Can you give us an idea of the routines you do now?
I feel that my material is risque, but it's not vulgar. And for example, you know, I do jokes about sex changes. You know, I'll say I have a very dear friend of mine who went abroad, came back abroad. You know, that kind of thing.
We're losing the satellite. We have to go. Thank you very much. Keep preaching.
Okay. God bless.
Sister Paula. I like her. She's her own man.